My son now helps me move aquariums, but at one point, you guys would remember him from naming fish of the likes of Frank the Flowerhorn and Tyrese the Fajaca Puffer.
It's...
Frank Jr.
Tyrese!
Tyrese?
Yes.
Oh! Get out.
Today, we set up Tyrese, his dream aquarium, the aquarium that he's been waiting for as long as anybody can remember. And look at the smile on his face. He knows what's coming. He knows that I've been planning on this for a while. I've been misleading everybody, saying he's going down in the basement and things like that. But what Tyrese really wants, he wants to come to the front of the gallery. Tyrese is sick and tired of every time I talk about the first aquarium you see when you walk in the gallery is the Piranha Aquarium, which certainly isn't a bad aquarium to walk into, but now he wants to be the second thing that you see when you walk into the gallery. Now look, I'm just right here. Look at my point of view. Piranha, Tyrese's aquarium, and we know darn well he's gonna come to this corner and look at us. You guys will remember I was planning on moving these 180s here, and we finally have and put them in place. You might be a little worried about how messy it is and how gross it might look, but you gotta remember, I've got these pine boards back here that I'm going to wrap around the top, and they'll eventually look like the saltwater stand. In fact, they'll be identical. I need to add some more paint, make it a little bit more pretty, but I'm absolutely obsessed right now with cinder block stands for two reasons. They're cheap, they're easy, they're probably the easiest do-it-yourself method, they're strong, plus if you ever need to take them apart or move them, you can do that, and maybe one day I'll have to move a fish tank. You know me, I rarely move any tanks or fish, but I'm now starting to become a little conscientious about moving stuff. Tyrese's tank is 180 gallons. It's 6 feet long, it's 2 feet tall, and it's 2 feet wide. I just chucked this light on it real quick for now. It's the same light that's on the 2000, but I'll move the cord or whatever. And I gotta clean the tank up because it still has water stains from what was in it last time. I've also had to level it up or level it off with some shims, and then to do so, you'll see a little bit here. The ground out here is not level. You don't want to level the tank. You want to level anything under the tank. I wasn't going to level the concrete blocks because I want them to be flat and sturdy. So I shimmed underneath of here. This is slightly lifted up, leveling it off. It was off by almost a half an inch, believe it or not. Now this might seem weird, but after I level a tank, I shake it in every direction. I want to see if it's wobbling. I want to make sure that all four corners are touching. I want to ensure that this is guaranteed to be flat and true. Otherwise, an unlevel tank is perfectly fine, technically safe. A bit of an eyesore, especially if it's from the lengthwise, like, you know, how it gets a little bit less water on one side than the other, kind of looks wonky. Safe, what you don't want is twisting. So if one corner's not touching or another corner's not touching, that can cause twisting in the bottom panel, putting strain on not only the seams, but the panels themselves, especially the bottom, and that can shatter it or at least crack it. Now, what have I been planning? You guys technically already know about it. Check out this background. Actually, check out this piece of wood with moss on it. This is all aqua decor. It's not real. They sent me this months ago, and I didn't know what I wanted to do, but I had to have it. It'll look much better once we get it in the tank, and you're gonna see how easy this type is to get in the tank. I'm just gonna stand it up, but it's the perfect look for Tyrese, isn't it? Absolutely gorgeous. We got some rocks and kind of like some branches or at least a tree root coming down, and then this moss is weighted. If we could take a closer look at it, maybe once we get in the tank we'll be able to see it, but it's weighted so it's not gonna float. Very, very cool looking. I'm really excited to get in the tank, and to get it in the tank, it doesn't matter if your tank has fish in it, water in it, or not. This new method is groundbreaking, at least to me, because I've had so many of these. They're suction cups now. You just pop it in the tank and suction cup it in place, and that's it. So let's see what we can do. Now, a lot of the times, these backgrounds look like they'd be difficult to get into a tank or with your braces or whatever, but they just bend all over the place, absolutely indestructible. When I got this, I had nowhere to store it. So for the past few months, it's been outside buried in snow, and it just defrosted earlier, and now it's ready to go in the tank. Look, the suction cups work so good. They're already sticking to the bottom of the tank. Oh, shoot. These suction cups are too good. I can't get it off. Damn, that sucked. So at least we know the suction cups work. This is the easiest type so far. I probably should have cleaned the back glass before doing this because it feels like some of these suction cups want to let go without being wet. But there we go. Oh, wow, this is going to be awesome. I need a stool. Not because I'm short. Okay, it's because I'm short. See, everything I need fits in here too, even though this is just a smaller space. I'm eventually going to be putting the pump behind the background, but for now, I don't have everything I need for the filter. So I'm kind of just focused on getting this kind of ready and scaped, kind of put together for now. Let me go from there. I love that there's so many of these suction cups too, because now I know for sure it's in its right spot. So that's in, that's complete, and boy, does that look good. Yeah, now we can really see the detail. And I think with this light, I'll keep it back here in the front, kind of. I might do this so I can get a little bit more depth to it, but light placement is incredibly important as well. With your aquariums. If you don't believe me, go move your lights around. If you got bored of your fish tank, move them to the back, move them to the front, the center. Everybody puts them in the center, but if you don't have plants, there's no reason to have your lights in a specific spot. Put them where it looks good. A lot of times, bringing it to the front adds depth to the tank, and putting it to the back can illuminate if you have backgrounds. And if you check out aquadecor.backgrounds.com, make sure you use promo code Joey15. You'll get 15% off. That's a new promo code. Well, relatively new. It's quite old, but I never talk about it. Okay, now for these sticks. Where should I put these? I'm thinking they should all kind of, the moss maybe should go out near the top. Another thing that we should talk about is what else is going in here. I'm not planting it. I do want to add in a bunch of tetras for Tyrese. He does actually really well with them. So we'll be doing that there here shortly as well. Maybe this one. No, this is more like a stick like this. Yeah. Kind of want to find a good placement. You kind of want it to be natural, but not too. Maybe something like that. Of course, I don't know for sure if I'm going to be doing it this way, because I still have something really cool I gotta add to here. These sticks are huge, really long. It's hard to find a good spot for them. I think this one should just lay on the ground. Like that, maybe. What's the end of it look like? No. I do like them all going in one direction, kind of complementing the background, how it's already kind of going anyway. Oh, yeah. That's actually a good idea like that. Maybe too close. I like kind of pressing these sticks into the backgrounds as well. Not only does it help with supporting the background and pushing it in, but it gives a little bit more dynamic to it as well. I like this background because it looks like it's taking up more space than it is, but it's really not. And we have plenty of space behind it, nooks and crannies for your heaters, filtration, so you completely hide everything. That's gonna look cool. Okay, another little thing we got are these little vines. Check this out. So, and each one of these vines, again, has moss on it. So what I'm thinking is I'm just gonna super glue them in place here and there. And like I said, we'll just chuck a bunch in there. We'll use them all. Well, we'll try to use them all. I think I'm gonna run out of glue before I run out of these twigs though. So that kind of sucks. luckily it dries rapidly. And I just want them to kind of be like flow freeing in the tank. Yeah, and now, well, Tyrese, maybe we could put in some plants like Anubias or something, but for the most part, I'm likely just going to put some substrate in it and call it a day, but we'll see. This looks good though. Oh yeah, it definitely looks like water should be coming this way. Filter again is gonna be an overhead filter with the returns pushing water that way, so it'd kind of be cycling in a circle, but what do you guys think? I think once it gets some algae and stuff in it as well, it's just gonna look even more incredible. Isn't this insane? I think this might be one of the better backgrounds that I have. Crazy that I have most aquariums with backgrounds, as because I never used to, but you guys will remember, I used to just do bare bottom tanks, big fish, nothing in it whatsoever. Yeah, I love that, and I like the fact that I could probably take these and push them even up against the background if I wanted to. And once I get substrate in, substrate will help hold them in place and whatnot. But the substrate we're gonna use is like this pea gravel type stuff. I wouldn't even know. It's like a really big grained sand, multicolored sort of, but more natural from Tyrese's tank. So it's cycled. There's about 2 inches on average throughout this 4 by 16 inch tank. I just need I don't even need half of this in the other tank. Just a dusting to cover the bottom. I don't need a massive amount. And then look at all of his Anubias. He's got a bunch. I've been doing no lights on this tank for over a month now, trying to kill the hair algae on it. I ended up putting them in the piranha tank and it just got worse. So I'm gonna have to definitely bleach dip these guys or do something to get rid of all of this hair algae on it that I can't seem to get rid of. All right, let's move on to the next step. So what you guys seen so far was last night, and I slept on it. And I have to say, I'm glad I did, because it just got better. Oh, and by the way, I cleaned the glass this time because I watched the footage back and you can't even see the tank. Oh, I gotta clean here. Oh, that's the inside. But this tank is absolutely gorgeous. It's darn near perfect if you ask me. Am I a fan of how much space we have in between here? Just like you, probably not, but would I rather not have this tank versus have it? I want it. You'll notice that it has white pine boards here now. I've added them, I gotta paint them black, and I added them to the other side, added a new little socket here for plugs, and all the electricals kind of just plugged in there. Kind of messy, I'll clean that up eventually, but we're ready to move to the next step of setting this tank up. I know two things. We need substrate, and we should probably get some plants. So I got both. So as mentioned, we're gonna take the substrate from Tyrese's aquarium. The downside is Tyrese can't come today. He's gonna have to come another time. But we're gonna be able to take his substrate to feed those plants and to get it kind of set up. I'm waiting on one little piece of plumbing to show up. I had to order it online. That's the beauty of living in a very small town. Not everything's here all the time, especially for a YouTuber that wants to make videos for his subscribers, but you know, sometimes you gotta play the game and wait for things to come. We're gonna move all the substrate over, seeding the tank immediately. Tyrese will stay in here with his cycled filter and all of his plants that is attached to lava rock, which will support him no problem. Plants I want to add, we got a lot of Java fern. How will I add them? Oh, I'm thinking, and just looking through this angle here, I'm thinking of adding some sporadically, just 4 bunches, and we have a lot. We have about 18 bunches, but I'm going to take all those 18, turn them into 4 bunches, and put them, I think I'm gonna glue some to the stick here, to the stick there, maybe to this stick, very sporadically, but not spread out throughout the entire aquarium, mostly concentrating over here. And we'll see how that goes, but I think we should add the substrate first and then add in the plants. So let's do that right now. So to add in the Java fern, I simply glued it to most of the sticks or to the sticks I wanted it to be attached to. Really quite simple. The substrate does seem to be the perfect amount and exactly what I was looking for. Basically a light dusting, just kind of to cover the bottom, not looking for anything too deep. But you'll also notice I went ahead and brought in all of my Anubias. I planted them randomly throughout the aquarium, kind of just putting them in the substrate a little bit. And then I brought in the big pieces. And everything's kind of just in there sporadically, but it definitely looks really good. Now, obviously, I got to get the filter hooked up, temperature brought up to temperature, or the tank brought up to temperature, and then, of course, we can also add Tyrese into it. But for the time being, I'd say this aquarium is done. Now, 180-gallon aquarium for one fish might seem like an awful lot, but Tyrese is pushing a foot long at this point, and the Fahaka Puffer can get a little bit bigger than that. He's definitely slowing down in growth. He is about 4 or 5 years old now. Fahaka Puffers are not necessarily incredibly fast growers, but you'll also notice that there's a tremendous amount of like hiding places and visual blocks for other fish to potentially be added into this. So when I do add in more tetras or something like that, it'll be incredibly difficult for Tyrese to kind of find them all and or attack them all or even see them all. So my question is, should I go with guppies or maybe I should go with some other sort of live bear? Should I try mollies or swordtails or... Because he seems to have gotten along with pretty much anything. Or should I try a few, like maybe 5 test fish? Like, I'd love to do some platies. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, just to add like a really fun splash of color to this. Obviously, it would ruin the naturalism to it. The colors of this tank kind of match Tyrese in the first place. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. And we'll go over there. But ultimately, there's only a few more things to do to it. I've got to finish painting this stand and get the equipment properly connected and hooked up. I might change the lights out. I don't know. But the filters are here. And I just need some plumbing supplies. Heck, I might even just toss his canister filter on there, because if we look over there, he's just got a spare canister running him because he's no longer on the sump. But ultimately, the next time he moves is into his main tank. I don't want to move him around too much. And when he does move, I could drain that tank and I could take out this entire racking system and begin building the other tanks that I need to build. But anyways, this aquarium came out far better than I thought. Obviously, it needs some time to kind of settle and get worked in a bit. But if you could imagine, hopefully all of that Java fern and Anubias really take off in this tank. Yeah, definitely cool. Now when you walk into the gallery, well, the piranha tank lights are off right now, but we'll see the piranha and then we will see Tyrese. And I'm taking bets that basically state that he's always gonna be over here looking at me. Yeah, super cool tank, really love it. Love the fact that it's the same height as the 2000. It's about 3 inches, 4 inches shorter, but that's so that when the light doesn't kind of peek up above the 2000 there. But yeah. Anyways, let me know what you guys think. It's first thing in the morning here. I'm trying to get this video out for you today. Hope you've enjoyed it, but this has gotta be one of the best versions of a puffer fish aquarium for an individual puffer. But he deserves it. He's been around for 5, 6 years now, so hope you guys like it. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. More importantly, what should we put with him? Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. See you in the next one.